Okay. So, we have found out all this. The other question that is asked is, what are the 0 member forces? Okay. That is a question for which, you know, it is not possible for me to solve for every one of the member forces. So, let us examine and see if it is possible for me to spot these 0 member forces. Okay. So, I am going to use a color to identify them. Okay. Now, let us start exploring the joints and see if there are any joints in which it is possible to take a direction along perpendicular to which there is only one force acting. Okay. If you look at it carefully, the joint K, the joint G are some of the candidates. Joint K has already a 10 kilonewton, which is compensated by BK, right, and therefore, I will avoid this, I will look at this particular joint. These 2 member forces are in the horizontal direction, only this member force is in the vertical direction, which automatically tells me that if I take vertical equilibrium at G, I will get EG to be 0. Okay. Well, if EG is 0, why would I have that member? Isn't it a good question? If the member is not taking a force, why would I have that, right? There are 2 reasons why we have this. One is, remember, this is vehicle movement. I could always get a vehicle to pass through this, during which there will be a downward load, right? Apart from that, it is also important for stability. Remember, this member DEF would have been very long if I had removed this part. The members EH and EG, if I remove, this would have been very long, and if it were in compression, it will easily buckle. I would seek to reduce the length of these members, right, and that is the reason sometimes there are additional members inserted. Okay. So, for now, just for analysis, we know that this member force is 0, I am just going to erase this, so that it is clearer for us to proceed further to see if there are any other likely 0 force members. Okay. So, I am just going to write one member that I have found out, which is EG. Let me use the other color, so that it is easy for you. These are 0 member forces. EG is fine, but it reveals one more important thing. If you look at this particular joint D, again we have a scenario where EH is perpendicular and there are no other forces acting along the perpendicular direction to this DEF, which means that this member should be a 0 force member. Let me remove this. How about this point? Well, there is this 20 kilonewton here, and therefore, there should be some force acting. Let us look at this particular point. Remember, this member will have some load, the horizontal component of which will have to be resisted by GF. So, this will not be 0, this will not be 0, this will not be 0, this will not be 0. This 20 kilonewton has to be taken by this, so this will not be 0. Right. If I take this particular scenario, this is not 0, this is not 0, correct. Let us go from here, again the same scenario, this is not 0, which means this is not 0, this is not 0, this is not 0. If I take this, this is not 0, this is not 0, right. So, let us look at this particular joint C. How about joint C? This is not 0, this is not 0, this is not. There is a likelihood that this is also not 0, because there are these non-zero force members. If you look at vertical equilibrium over here, there is this 20 kilonewtons, this force is also not 0. So, there is a likelihood that this is not 0, right. Similarly, this is also not 0. The only one left out are these two. We have already found out those two, and we found that those two are not 0. These two will give rise to a member force here, which means this is not 0. So, we have found that EG and EH happen to be 0 force members. Okay. This is a nice way to do it. If I erase, it reveals to me that this is also likely to be 0. If I had not done that, it would have been very difficult for me to identify EH to be a 0 force member.